sister asks from Tanzania. She says, in the, and the translation being, ما حكم من يتعامل مع أهل البدع وحكومة الكافرة. So the question being, what is the ruling with regard to interacting or cooperating with the innovators or the people of innovation, and also the disbelieving hukuma or governments?
يا بنتي من تنزانيا قلت الحكومة الكافرة وأنا لا أدري عن حكومتكم هل هي حكومة نصرانية أو الحكام مسلمون فأحذرك أنت ومن يسمع من إطلاق هذا اللقب فإن المتحزبة من الإخوان المسلمين وما تفرع منها من سرورية وقطبية يطلقون التكفير جزافا حتى وإن كان الحاكم مسلما والواجب علينا يا بنتي أن لا نجاري هؤلاء هذا أول ما أنصحك به وثانيا التعامل مع المبتدعة في البيع والشراء هذا جائز نعم إذا وجد أصحاب سنة تتوفر حاجاتنا لديهم فنطلبهم واعلمي كذلك أن الصلاة خلف أصحاب البدع صحيحة إلا من كانت بدعتهم مكفرة كالرافضة وأصحاب وحدة الوجود وأصحاب الحلول والاتحاد والقديمية فهؤلاء لا تصح الصلاة خلفهم بقي التعامل مع حكومة البلد إذا كانت كافرة يهودية أو نصرانية أو مجوسية فإن من دخل في وظائف هذه الحكومة لكسب رزقه ومنفعة المسلمين فلا بأس بذلك إن شاء الله تعالى أما من دخل معهم يضر المسلمين ويؤذيهم ويناصر الكفار عليهم فهذا محرم وراتبه من الكسب الحرام فأطلب إليك يا بنتي أن تطلب العلم الشرعي حتى تفهمي كيف تطلق الأحكام وتفرق بين الأمور فإن الجهل بالأصول الشرعية يورث الجور والظلم ويورث اللبس والخلط في الأحكام فتنبهي جيدا يا بنتي ولتنبه السامعون والسامعون من المسلمين والمسلمات والله الهادي إلى سواء السبيل
So the question was regards, what is the ruling regarding cooperating with the people of innovation and the disbelieving governments. So the Sheikh Hafidhullah, he began by saying, oh my daughter, the one who's asking from Tanzania, you said that the government that you're referring to is a disbelieving government. And I myself, the Sheikh says, I myself do not actually know yani the situation of your government, whether it is disbelieving or whether it is a Christian government, for example. So the Sheikh Hafidhaullah says that you have mentioned this. And what I would like to point out to you, those who are listening, is that the mutahazziba, those groups which are formed upon partisanship from the groups like the Ikhwan al-Muslimin, like the Muslim Brotherhood group and the Qutubiyya group, those who follow the way of Sayyid Qutb, and the Sururiyya group, those who follow the way of Muhammad Surur, for example, these particular types of groups, they are the ones who are known for this. They are the ones who make itlaq, who generalize when they speak about the government like this. So, we should not follow their way, and we should be careful at least in following their particular path of generalizing governments being disbelieving or being disbelievers. Secondly, Sheikh Hafidhaullah said that the ta'awun or the cooperation with the disbelievers as regards buying and selling, this is allowed. And as regards the innovators as well, this is allowed. However, if one is able to cooperate firstly, as opposed to that, from somebody from the people of Sunnah, then this is what is required. And as for the prayer behind the innovators, the people of innovation, this is allowed. Except for those whose innovations are in belief such as the Rawafid, or the people who are the Rafida, which are extreme sect of the Shia, and those who believe in Wahdatul Wujud, who believe in Wahdatul Wujud, that Allah is in everything and everything is in Allah. You see, Kirk Shundar. Or, for example, those who follow the path of the Qadiyaniya, who say to the Prophet after Muhammad, these types of groups who have innovations in their belief, which is a form of shirk, these types, the Shaykh says, are not allowed to pray behind from the people of innovation. And then the Shaykh Hafidhaullah said, as for cooperation with the Christians, or the Jews, or the Majus, the fire worshippers, then this is allowed in terms of, as you mentioned, buying and selling interactions. And for example, he says, whoever enters or whoever actually gains some sort of position with the government, with these types of governments, disbelieving governments, whether they be Christian, Jews, or of the Majus, and he does so in order to aid the Muslims, and he does so to earn a livelihood, then this is labat, this is allowed, inshallah, Allah willing. As for if the person gains this type of wazifa, this type of work, where he harms the Muslims, and he aids the disbelievers over them, then this one, this type is not allowed, and even his kasb, even his earning that he earns from his salary, is not allowed. Even his earning is prohibited, is unlawful. So my daughter, I advise you to learn, to study knowledge, which is the Islamic knowledge, which is legislated, Islamic legislated knowledge, such that you do not, and other than you do not, generalize in your rulings in various affairs. For indeed, ignorance brings about oppression, or it leads to oppression and leads to committing injustice, and also ignorance, jahl, it leads to yani making the affairs unclear and also making the rulings and regulations mixed without clarity. So pay attention to this affair yourself, as well as those who are listening from the Muslims, male and female.